class we're taking is Structural Collapse 3. It's a very in-depth training. It's a week long. It's a very hard class, but it's a lot of hands-on skills and a lot of practical knowledge that we'll use in the field.
Basically, shoring up the external portions of the building has nothing to do with interior stuff. It's all external stuff. Stabilizing the outside of the building so we can get ready to send the guys to the interior portion for search and rescue operations.
It's pretty much all hands-on, very minimal, sitting in a classroom, watching PowerPoints, putting yourself to sleep. It's a lot of either group taskings, going over, doing group briefings, hands-on, hanging, banging nails.
We build the 6x6 breaker shores that they don't normally get to build in SCT class. We do double insertion point split sole breaker shores with splices in the rakers, splices in the wall plates, similar to what they're doing behind us right here.
We had to calculate in and measure off our normal 45 degree. We had to take and subtract 5 degrees on one side and up to 8 on the other side. And, we put it all together and everything worked.
It's 3 stories high and we have to compensate for uneven slope in the ground. So there's a lot of math involved and a lot of unusual things going on.
We don't want the rookies. We want the guys who are gonna come in here with some previous experience, good training, and engaged. They're the ones that get the most out of it.
Doing a triple insertion point would be very applicable to our area where we might have some sort of a tilting wall going exterior and have to make access to the building. So for me, it was just kind of taking the basic skills we learned from way back when during the basic course and taking it to a whole new level and thinking outside the box.
We have people in Japan, from Puerto Rico.
A lot from Texas, some from Michigan, Illinois, I believe Nebraska.
Local fire departments, regional technical rescue teams, all the way through state suicide team, and there's a few of us from the federal system as well.
Meeting with them and interacting with them and building relationships with those guys right there. That's my favorite part of it.
You can't express enough how knowledgeable these guys are. They're giving us stuff that we can't even think of yet because we haven't been there in real life. So what we're seeing and what they're giving us is just a wealth of knowledge.
For me, it's a privilege to get to be able to study under them and kind of because they're right on the cutting edge of, as far as structural collapse training goes, along with they've all got operational experience. They can bring it to your level and just talk you right through whatever level you're at to get you to what you need to do. A lot of credibility comes with these guys.
I've already spoken to my director back in Michigan, and I told him that if he can send more people, then he should.